fascinating to see Elizabeth Holmes on the stand testifying in her own criminal trial. She talked a lot about her origin story. Growing up in Houston, can get highly technical in the courtroom, and there's been a lot of defining, even spelling of words. At one point, the attorneys for Elizabeth Holmes asked her to spell out a word because it was new to most of the people in the courtroom, Lindsay.
Oh, wow.
She has a very calm and collected demeanor. When she takes her mask off, which is her right to do when she begins her testimony, she does nothing flusters her on the stand right now, Lindsay. And when we look at Elizabeth Holmes herself, so many of the witnesses we've heard from already in this trial, the 29 government witnesses, have laid out these allegations. Wanted to change the world. That is the story that we've heard so far. But of course, we know this is a story that goes on for many years. She ran Theranos from 2004 to 2018, and we're basically in the time frame of 2010 right now. There is a lot of ground to cover still at this trial. And lastly, is that we will have something of a verdict before Christmas. The jury, the 12 members of this jury, are not sequestered. They are going about their lives, and there's an acknowledgement among the legal experts I speak to that once you get into the holiday period, you really create issues with people going back home, spending time with families, that potential for hearing something, and then the greater potential for a mistrial. So there's a real desire at this court to get things wrapped up by Christmas. That would be a few more weeks of trial, and we definitely expect to hear from Elizabeth for the rest of this week. That's tomorrow, and then into next week as well after Thanksgiving, Lindsay.
Rebecca Jarvis, thank you so much. Be sure to catch the